All right, welcome back to Computer Vision. And when I say back, I took a whole week off. So basically, I have no idea where we are. So hopefully, you'll be more get your act together than I do. I think last time we were talking something about the Lucas-Kanade method of solving for optical flow or for motion. And if you remember, we had this problem with optical flow that we refer to as the aperture problem. The aperture problem was if you look at a little local area, and you can only tell the motion that is in the direction of the gradient perpendicular to the edge. So basically, to solve that, we had to impose some form of constraints. First, we did the global constraints, then we did the local constraints of Lucas and Kanade. And the idea was by having these local constraints, we could have more than one equation per pixel. And the basic idea was to pretend that all the pixels were moving in the same direction in a little local neighborhood, so we would sum up over that window. We said a 5x5 window, you'd have 25 equations per pixel. And that basically gave us this least square solution, and we related that to the whole Harris corners, where we said that if the matrix here, A transpose A, if that matrix was well conditioned, meant we had two decent sized eigenvalues, it meant that the gradient occurred in various directions over that window. And we mentioned how this method of recovering how something moved was first proposed by Lucas-Kanade in 1981. But critical to the whole derivation was the idea that we use this Taylor series expansion, that is, that we could approximate how something would move or how much the intensity would change by essentially fitting a planar ramp. That was the first order derivative approximation, fitting a planar ramp to a point, and then as the point would move, the intensity would change according to the slope on that ramp. But of course, there were certain assumptions built into Lucas-Kanade that were sometimes problematic. So the main assumption was that the pixel as it moved didn't change its color, didn't change its intensity. So if brightness constancy doesn't hold, then you have to do something in terms of feature detection, finding a feature from one place to another. And we've already talked about doing SIFT detection and characterization in order to do these matches. And we can combine those. In fact, we're not going to, but I'll talk at the very end about how you can combine dense estimation with SIFT estimation. The other thing we said is that possibly a bunch of points are moving one way and another points are moving another way. So in that area, within a window, you don't actually have all the points moving in the same direction. And you have to solve that with a motion segmentation. We mentioned that. We'll actually go over sort of a mechanism of doing that, not at the end of this lecture, but at the end of the next one. Oh, these aren't lectures. These are videos. So that makes them sound like they're more fun.